How old is he?
I'm Pamela Selz, and officially I'm a volunteer with Harrison Hospital in their complementary therapies section. I do pet therapy. I bring in one of my dogs who I've certified with the organization, with a pet therapy organization, and we visit the staff, we visit the patients, the families, everybody who's there.
The program's been around for 6 years. And in that time, in a year, typically we see almost 2,000 patients, visitors, staff combined. So it has a pretty large impact. We have 8 teams, and they visit in our Bremerton Medical Center and also in Paulsbo Hematology and Oncology.
This is Levi, and he is 9 months old. He's very tired right now because he was visiting at the nursing home earlier today. He is the sweetest boy. He's very mellow. He seems to get it that, you know, unless we're home, that he needs to kind of be behaved and check out everything. And that's really what I need in a therapy dog, especially one who's this big. He's 140 pounds right now, and he still has a long way to go to grow. You don't want a dog that big being out of control.
Pet therapy is important because it is in line with our approach to treating the whole patient. And we really want to help patients feel comfortable, relaxed, reduce any side effects or symptoms. And the great thing is that with pet therapy, we can do some of that non-pharmacologically. And so, you know, we work in tandem with conventional healthcare, and, you know, just seeing a pet and petting its fur, people can have decreased anxiety, depression, it's distraction, it can decrease pain perception. There's just several different benefits to, you know, having that interaction with one of our dogs.
Thank you.
We've met with patients who had recently been given a diagnosis of cancer. It's very devastating for them, and sometimes their family's not right there. And here we are. And while they're crying, they're petting the dog and getting comfort from that, from this warm dog that's right next to them, who's not passing judgment, who's just there to give back the love. And that in and of itself can be so calming and reassuring for them to know that, okay, I've just been dealt this really horrible blow of a really nasty diagnosis, but life goes on and there's this world out there and things like dogs to continue to love and be happy about. So it can mean a lot of things to, different things to a lot of different people.